Listen to me. Will you turn with me to book of Numbers? Ennagamam, 11th chapter, 29 words. Numbers 11, 29. And 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 3. Verse 3 and 13. And 13.
Then Moses said to him, "Are you zealous for my sake? Oh, that all the Lord's people were prophets, and that the Lord would put his spirit upon them. I wish you all spoke with tongues, but even more that you prophesy. For he who prophesies is greater than he who speaks with tongues, unless indeed he interprets, that the church may receive edification." 30. Therefore, let him who speaks in a tongue pray that he may interpret.
I give you the gist, you have to develop it. Moses cried, or the Holy Spirit through Moses opens his heart and shows his longing for the people of God. The Holy Spirit cry for the people of God comes through Moses. What is the cry? You know the story. Moses, all alone, almost 120 years, carrying millions of people on his shoulder, we get exhausted even with 100 people in this age. But Moses, 100 plus years, he was carrying the whole millions of people, nearly 30 million cow, donkey, horse. He has to give food for them. And the Israelites are notorious murmuring people. I want to tell you one thing. As you are going, one of the big, highest leakage for the anointing and the power of the Holy Spirit is complaining. All the Israelites died in Israel except Caleb and Joshua. The main sin is complaining. Negative talk. In my experience, I have seen people who constantly complain. They open up for cancer, or they open up for other adultery sin. Somewhere they lose the greatest treasure. Complaining, murmuring. For me, this is the number one attack on the children of God's people. Having in the ministry for 45 years, if you ask me, Anna, what has drained your energy? What has affected your ministry more than anything else is people who complain, talk negative, finding fault. I tell you, this drains a man of God. Please, I told you already, Moses was the meekest man on the earth. I didn't say, God wrote it, God. It's not your testimony about yourself. It's not your other's testimony about you. The Creator said, he is the softest, meekest man on the earth. Clap your hands for Moses. But such a man couldn't handle the murmurers, backbiters. Why do I say that? Not I say it. The Holy Spirit says, hate complaining, or murmuring or dissatisfaction or backbiting. To the core, you would be a possessor of your Canaan. You will possess the nation. You will possess the glorious ministry. Otherwise, on the way, you are gone. It's not how you start the ministry. It's how you are going to complete the ministry. That you have to keep it as a goal. Are you listening? People will talk about you. The Bible says, if all men praise you, woe unto you. எல்லாரும் உங்களை புகழ்ந்தால் உங்களுக்கு ஐயோ கேடு. All men praise you, danger. I don't expect it. Some people, as long as you are alive, they will talk negative. The moment you die, they will talk positive. I used to tell them, if they have talked such a nice word about you before you died, you would have lived 10 more years extra. Moses couldn't bear it. So what happened? You know that even he missed Canaan. He couldn't enter. The man who carried millions of people on his shoulder, he couldn't go into Canaan. Not because of him. They irritated him so much. I see the believers. If salt, little salt less, that heavenly salt out. If the husband comes 10 minutes late, wait. You mark it, you see it, you check it. Very easily you pass negative comments about people. After walking with God, I'm not perfect, but still I tell you, even now when I talk negative about somebody, immediately I lose the consciousness of God's presence in me. God is in you. He doesn't go. But that consciousness helps you to walk in victory. So Moses, here, you know, if there is no water, they will complain. If there is no meat, they will not complain. Then angel's food will be here. After some time, angel food also bor lagta hai. They will complain. And he couldn't bear it. You know what he said? Moses talked to God so frank. Am I a mummy? Did I bring a, was I pregnant with them and delivered these, all these people? Why do you ask me to carry all of them on my shoulder? And he said, God, please kill me. Kill me and take me to heaven. Kill me. Even he wanted God to do the murder. So fed up. So fed up. And God said, don't worry, Moses. It's not by your natural energy you are a prophet or carrying. I put my spirit in you. That spirit only carried you all these years. It's not you. It's the spirit that I put upon you. But you didn't know it. You complain. But it's not you, my son. When I call a prophet, when I call an apostle or evangelist, pastor, I give them the spirit that will withstand all the attacks. Don't make fuss of what people talk about you. Laugh it. Only a fruitful tree, boys will throw the stone. If you have no fruit, nobody will care about you. (Laughter) I never expect all to appreciate me. Never. If I expect that everybody to appreciate me, I am a fool. Don't make it fuss, please. You have your calling. You have your calling. You cannot waste it. You cannot waste your time. Harbal brahato? Yes or no? Okay. So Moses, God said, kill me, Lord. God said, Moses, I understand. Not only you suffer, Moses, I also suffer with these people. I also suffer with these people. None of these people can enter into their possessions. I have seen adulterers jump out and shine and possess, but the complainers go on the way. Bully rule. Then God said, okay, for your satisfaction, for your, because the spirit I have given you is more than enough to handle 10 million or 100 million. But you don't see it, you complain it. Okay, tomorrow morning, bring all your 70 leader, and make them to stand around the tabernacle. I will come. And you know, he didn't say, I will come and give them spirit, my spirit. He will say, I will come and take your spirit, Moses' spirit, your spirit, and put it upon the 70. It's like a candle. When you take one candle, yes or no? When you take one candle and you light 70 candles, will this candle become small? By putting your fire or your recognition to other people, if they shine more than you, you cannot lose. By others shining through you, or even better than you, the candle doesn't die. The candle lights 70. It's also burning, others also burning. So God told Moses, I will bring them. The next day he brought 70 leaders. And God came down. He came and took Moses' spirit and put it on 70. The Bible says, all the 70, the moment the spirit came, they began to prophesy. The moment the Holy Spirit comes upon you, he already came, all of you can, should, must prophesy. If you don't prophesy, it's not that you don't have that spirit. The Holy Spirit himself is a spirit of prophecy. Holy Spirit is a healing spirit. You don't need a gift, you need a person. It's not healing, the healer. This one truth, I put it in your mind and spirit. I don't know how much more I can do it. All the 8 days, 9 days, this is what I am doing. Hallelujah. All began to speak in tongues. Sorry. All began to pray, prophesy. Everybody says 70 people came.
70 people came.
The spirit came.
The spirit came.
All prophesied.
All prophesied.
But you know, only 68 came. Two didn't come. Two didn't come. 70 people, 68 were present around the tabernacle, two could not come. But the Bible says, in the people who were sitting and coughing in the bedroom, my translation, the spirit came upon them, they were coughing and prophesying. See, when I said coughing, you would have not clapped your hand. When I said coughing and prophesying, you started prophesying. So the two were prophesying. One man came running to Moses. Joshua, do you know? These two people are disobedient. They didn't come when Moses called. They are sitting in the room. upon them the Holy Spirit came. How can they prophesy? Immediately Joshua felt he is a bodyguard to Moses. He thought, Moses, stop them. Can I go and stop them? You are your leader. When you said it, they don't obey it. For every leader, some people will do that. So what happened? Moses said, oh, you are jealous for my reputation. Huh? Oh, tears were rolling in his eyes. Oh, all God's people were prophets. And if the Spirit come upon all God's people, how nice it would be. Oh, all God's people can prophesy. All can have the Holy Ghost. That's the longing and heart cry of prophets. Moses. I tell you, it's not his longing, it's his prayer, it's his burden, it's God given. Because of that, God said, yes, Moses, I see you crying that all prophets, all God's people become prophets. I will do it, not in your time. After the day of Pentecost, I will pour out my Spirit upon all flesh. And your sons and daughters shall prophesy. And Paul, he also says, crying like this in 1 Corinthians, well, you read it, in 1 Corinthians 14:5. I wish, in other words, I desire, in other words, I cry that all of you speak in tongues, all of you prophesy, and all of you interpret your own language. His desire is three. He says, I wish that all of you pray in tongues. Then he said, yeah, but more than that, I wish all of you prophesy. Then he said, even if you pray in tongues, at least pray for interpretation. The Bible says in verse 13, I read it to you. All of you say it. He that speaks in tongues. Must pray. He may interpret it. Shout it.
He that speaks in tongues. Must pray that he may interpret it.
Musta illa okay va?
Must.
Shout.
Must.
God says, say it with me. God says.
I must.
No option. I must.
Pray.
That what I pray in tongues.
I must interpret it.
Can I ask you, how many of you prayed, Lord, whatever I pray in tongues, let me interpret it? Did you pray? Okay. Do you pray often? Are you walking in obedience or disobedience? The problem is we focus on this sin and that sin and this sin. This is also God's commandment, you know. God said, don't commit adultery. Oh, serious. You must pray for tongues. Who asked you to give a mark? This is more important, this is less important. That's why the church doesn't walk in victory, walk in glory. Did you understand? Okay, with this introduction, I come to the tongues. Why Paul liked, all of us must speak in tongues. Why? Lift your hand in the fasting day and say, Father,
Father,
every Christian in India,
every
Christian in the world, no matter what denomination they are, Catholics, Lutherans,
Methodists,
Baptists, Seventh-day, whoever, Lord,
we pray,
let all of them pray in tongues, let the Spirit come upon all of them.
Let the Spirit come upon all of them.
Let all of them prophesy. That should be your prayer constantly.
Amen.
That's the answer for nation's transformation. I thank God for people who don't believe in speaking in tongues. I am not upset, but I am extremely sad. You don't know what they miss. They don't know what they miss. I tell you, if you ask me, I told you already, without this special ability to pray in tongues, Ezekiel would have gone long before. From my side, the number one thing that keeps me going is praying in tongues. I will not... That's the only thing that keeps me going. Even in the younger age, I used to pray in Tamil and shout as much as possible. I shout and shake as much as possible. Nowadays, you know me, you know how many years and how many years I have trained, how much I have poured out, how energy I will have. You know what? I do it because of this praying in tongues. I keep going. You know why? When I come here and I open my mouth and the messages comes without anything for hours, it's the secret is praying in tongues. I pray in tongues. I cannot tell you how many hours I pray in tongues. Almost when I get up until I come to the pulpit, I am praying in tongues. Sometimes it could be 7 hours, sometimes it could be 10 hours, something it could be 3-4 hours. John G. Lake, that is a mighty man. The miracles he did, I would recommend you to get his books. John G. Lake, I want you to read the successful people who ended their ministry successfully. That will help you much more than the present authors. And John G. Lake, you know, he writes one word. What is the secret of your ministry? He healed millions of people. One time he called all the testimonies. Only for a testimony he arranged the biggest auditorium in South Africa, and millions of people, all the stretchers, wheelchair, everywhere, and people who could not come, many millions of letters of testimonies. He writes in his book, praying in tongues made my ministry. Baraka, trainees, delegates must be branded as tongue talkers speaking in the Holy Ghost all the time. In the toilet, you can. Bathing time, you can. Cycling, you can. Cooking, you can. When you cook, Chandra Bal Balbla Hatur Bashkar Bahando Vulba Subhumal Malhatra Shakar Bahata, cook it. The food will be so anointed. Nothing is here. This man doesn't care about it. I have to cook for everybody. This is my life, all my life. You cook it. All your children will have diarrhea, your husband will have diarrhea, and 20 years ago he will close his eyes and go. The praying in tongues, I will just give you because I cannot go deeper. That's one of my favorite subjects. I have written a book, Wonder Way to the Wonder World. I have said all supernatural gifts inaugurated, it trigger is tongues. Even on the day of Pentecost, the Bible says in Acts of the Apostles, they began, everybody say, began to speak in tongues.
To speak in tongues.
Acts 2:4. Then you read all the Acts of the Apostles up to 28 chapter. Almost every chapter, miracles. That's the early church. Early church was born in miracle. All through they had miracle. But the Bible says, began with tongues. Say it with me. Praying in tongues.
Praying in tongues.
Releases miracles.
Releases miracles.
Releases prophecy.
Releases prophecy.
Releases interpretation.
Releases interpretation.
Opens your spiritual eyes.
Opens your spiritual eyes.
Gives the words of wisdom.
Gives the words of wisdom.
Halbarakato. That's the trigger. Even first Pentecostal preaching, Peter, you know, he didn't prepare a sermon because he didn't expect a congregation. They were praying in tongues. They didn't even know when the Spirit will come. Suddenly the Spirit came. All began to speak in tongues. When they were like a drunker, suddenly the crowd came. 5,000, 3,000, 6,000 people everywhere. He didn't know what to do. He never preached in such a big meeting ever in his life. Only Jesus will preach. He will clap the hands. And when they were, how long they were praying in tongues, I don't know. When the crowd came, he stood up. And he said, oh people, this is that was spoken by Joel. Mada, mada, tada, dada, 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 dada. The words are coming, the words are coming. In all the Old Testament scriptures are coming. And you know, the message came. Can I tell you, it was not a prepared sermon. It was not a computer sermon. It's a communion sermon. Get ready for that. If you read the whole Acts of the Apostles, no preacher ever prepared. Some people say, Ezekiel, Anna, I like that. I also never pray, Anna. Never prepare. I go and preach, Anna. Matiala shata malamarata. That's not what I am saying. Some people, whole Saturday marketing, whole Friday shopping, whole Thursday fishing, whole and TV, and Sunday morning put on the nice dress. Oh, people, God is in this place. Oh, wow. Peter was praying in tongues. We don't know how many hours. The fire came upon him. Out of that, suddenly he opened his mouth. The Niagara River was flooding. Thousand people, one sermon, were convicted. They screamed, brethren, stop preaching. Now we are not ready to hear. Please tell us what we should do. He said, okay, now only very short now. Repent. Yes. be baptized. Yes, be filled with the Spirit. Yes. Then they have to 12 people ma, 3,000 people baptism. Imagine 3,000 people. That's the power of praying in tongues. This gift triggers, releases all other gifts. That's why Jesus, before going to heaven, he said, these signs shall follow them that believe. In one breath, he said, all five. They will pray in tongues, they will pray in new language, and they will take up the serpent. Even if you give them the poison, give a poison. Mandiloroshanda. But one thing, when the poison is given, then don't start talking in tongues. Some people, the poison, huh? Shundabala, shundabala bread. Isaiah 28. Isaiah 28.
Whom will he teach knowledge?
Everybody shout with me. Whom?
Whom? Will he teach knowledge?
All of you read it.
And whom will he make to understand the message?
Number one, to whom he will teach
knowledge.
Shout it. Teaching knowledge.
Teaching knowledge.
Number two.
Whom will he make to understand the message?
Understanding the message. Number two.
Understand the message. Those just weaned from milk, those just drawn from the breasts. For precepts must be upon precept, precept upon precept, line upon line, line upon line, here a little, there a little. For with stammering lips and another tongue he will speak to this people, to whom he said, this is the rest with which you may cause the weary to rest, and this is the refreshing. Yet they would not hear, but the word of the Lord was to them, precept upon precept, precept upon precept, line upon line, line upon line, here a little, there a little, that they might go and fall backward and be broken and snared and caught.
Listen, with stammering lips and foreign language, strange language, he will speak to his people. Say it with me. God himself
speaks to his people
through their own tongue. Everybody say, my God
can speak to me
using my own tongue. And my God
can speak to others
through my own tongue. This language is God's language. Listen, there are many varieties of praying in tongues, speaking in tongues. Number one, sometimes in tongues you will be praying to God. Romans 8:26, you know it. Listen, that prayer is, you will receive a burden from the Holy Spirit and you don't know what to pray. The Holy Spirit, who knows everything, he knows God's secret, you know what's happening to you, you know the future, he will possess your tongue and pray through you. So why I pray in tongues before I come here? If I start praying with my mind, I can't pray much. Bless them, Lord. Heal them, Lord. Change them, Lord. Transform them, Lord. Then what, Lord? So what I do, I keep all of you in my heart. I remember the faces. If I don't remember the face, at least I see this row, this row, this row, this row, this row. I see in my spirit. And I don't know what your problem is, what is your struggle, what kind of burden you have. I don't know it. I get into tongues. I say, Holy Spirit, I don't know what I should pray for them. You only know. They look very recently dressed and sitting before me. They clap their hand. They laugh at me. When I say la 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 la, they are enjoying it. But what do I know about their problem? What do I know about their struggle? You pray through me. I get into tongues. And I pray for 1 hour, 2 hours, 3 hours. I want to tell you another secret. When you pray in tongue, don't stop till you feel inner joy or inner release or inside something went out of you. Till that time, you have to pray in tongue. Are you happy? This I am giving you tips. Sometimes the burden will come. One time we had a very powerful fasting prayer, 3 days. My daddy was all in all. He was conducting. He was all in all and very healthy. My daddy and I am leaving another city, another place. And both of us coming into the car and some Israelites were sitting there. When I was about to come, my heart became very heavy. Heavy means suddenly when your heart becomes very heavy, you should not be ignoring. That could be the Holy Spirit is alerting you or giving you burden. Sometimes the devil also may make you heavy, that you have to discern and cast it out. So when I get, you know, Lord, what is this? What is this? Sudden heaviness, and the Holy Spirit, I began to feel. My daddy will die. I was shocked. So I get into the car and Israelites were there. So what happened? They are talking to me. They were waiting to talk to Ezekiah. They are coming from Israel. I talked to them. They talked to me. But my heart couldn't stop. I am praying in tongues, praying in tongues. Thank God we were sitting in the back car, no light. They didn't see my lips. I am talking. It went on for, when such a burden comes, you should start praying in tongues. Because the burden of the Holy Spirit can come in you. Or somebody in your family, somewhere in your congregation, or somebody in the world, maybe in danger, the Spirit of God in you, start praying for them. You must be sensitive. After 1 hour, I think 2 hours, suddenly it lifted up. I came, within 15 days, my daddy had a heart attack. Exactly. I saw it like that. We all cried and took him to the hospital. Then second attack. Thank God. The Holy Spirit alerted me. And I prayed in tongue. And I didn't stop till I got the victory inside. He's still alive. 88 years plus. That's the blessing of praying in tongues. Sometimes it's called praying language. There is another, when you see, listen, the Holy Spirit came to help you. Yes or no? Huh? Help you. Yes or no? Help you in what? Help you in every area. This helper. In your house, maybe some helper will only cook. When you say, clean my toilet, they will say bye-bye. But this helper, Holy Spirit, help you for your body, for your spirit, for your soul, for your family, for your every area. He doesn't help you only spiritual area. He help you in all the areas. Even when you make a chapati, the Holy Spirit will say, "Pulla, beti, this is not the way you do it." He will tell you. It's the Holy Ghost. He wants to help us in every area. Even when you drive, the Holy Spirit will say, "Hey, stop!" When you will put a brake, some car will about to hit. So what will happen? The Holy Spirit in you will alert you and would pray through you. I told you, God in you cannot do anything without you. God did miracle through Moses, but before that he said, Moses, what do you have? And then he said, I had a rod. He said, okay, come. He wanted to bless 5,000 people with five bread. He didn't say, let all of them sit. Father, and the bread came in his hand. Listen, he didn't, bread. He said, go and find, what do you have? Here is a small boy. Enough, bring. Everybody say, the Holy Spirit in me uses my own tongue.
Uses my own tongue.
My own hands.
My own hands.
My own body.
My own body.
My own eyes.
My own eyes.
To manifest his gifts.
To manifest his gifts.
I tell you, it may look very simple to you, but it took Anna for many, many years. People think the miracle will fall from heaven like a mango. Lord, do a miracle, Lord. Nothing happened. Do a miracle. Yeah, wait, I put it from heaven. It's your own body. So, when there is a problem, see, my daddy, the devil, planned to kill. The spirit in me rose up. And what I have to give to him? What I have to supply to the Holy Spirit? My tongue. How long I have to give to him till he wants? That's my cooperation. That's why I am his co-worker. You understand it? Oh, thank you, Jesus. So, sometime, everybody say sometime.
When the principalities,
powers,
wicked spirits,
spirit of adultery,
spirit of division,
inside the church,
inside the family,
spirit of lie,
or spirit of heathenism,
can stand against you. So you don't know how to handle the demon. You bound it. I bind you. I have seen people in the whole world, believers only, shout it all the time. I bind you. Till they shout, the throat become bound. Apparently, what? I could not speak. Why? I am fighting with the devil. I am doing spiritual warfare. The devil will say, I am binder, won't throat out. At such times, the divine helper, the almighty warrior, the Holy Spirit rises in you. When he rises, you don't know the Holy Spirit's a different phase. Sometimes he will be like a dove, cry. Sometimes he will be so humorous. Sometimes you will see him the angriest person. He has emotion. When you are full of God, you are a variety guy. Not always same. Kataru Stotram. You are unpredictable. Okay. Then what happened? When such an attack comes, you may not know it. When you are praying in tongues, Andrabal, Bela, Atulma, Haval Sokrimanaha, Homa, Mamal Mari, Atil Sukulbakanda, suddenly the Holy Spirit will see a demon or some spirit against you. He will rise up in you like a lion. The dove become a lion. Yeah, telisop mangiliyatala. Telasopikrivin. Balmarikato. Yeah, valimanakurabala. Yatala kalaba. you can see the voice, you can see the change of new language, you can see the anger. You must understand, wow, the helper is fighting my battles. That's what the Bible says in Ephesians 6:18. You can read it from 10. When you are in the battle, put on all the armor of God. Put on the righteousness, shield and chapel and helmet and everything. But when you have all the armor, righteousness, I am the righteousness of God. I am the righteousness of God. He is my shield. He is my shield. He is. You can do everything. But the verse 18 says, praying in the Holy Ghost. Read it.
Praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit.
Ah, listen everybody. Say it with me. All your armor.
All your armor.
All your righteousness.
All your righteousness.
Even the shield of faith.
Even the shield of faith.
Must be. Soaked in the prayer of the Holy Ghost.
Soaked in the prayer of the Holy Ghost.
Did you understand it?
Yes.
Ashko repil para, come on, pray in tongue. So what happened? That's why I am a very smart Annan. I don't bind, I don't lose. Anna, you don't bind? No. You don't lose? No. I don't even pray. You are here so many days, I didn't pray for you. I am smart. I know the one who lives in me is far better. So I allow him. Suddenly I get into the tongue. Mandilel, sabriman kalka. Tell, vasko bitten kalkala truana, yellamal. Ba, velisoka parasanda. I don't know to whom he is fighting. What kind of demon he is shout? Why should I bother? Yeah, mera kaam nahi hai. Suddenly, I cry in my prayer like that. I don't know for whom he is crying. I just yielded vessel. Have thine own way. Have thine own way, thou art the potter, I am the clay. That's why God said, this is not your battle, this is my battle. My battle means, shut up your mouth, I will do it. Did you understand this? So there is a word, praying language, there is a warfare language, that when you are in the spirit, you will know it. But there is another language. God himself will speak through you. God himself. I don't want to go very deep. Get the CD. That's why God said, he that prays in tongues must pray. He may interpret it. When you interpret it, you know what you are praying. You know why you are crying. You know what kind of prayer you are praying. Or sometime, listen. How many of you know Moses and God spoke face to face? Tell me. Is it a face to face prayer, one side prayer, or double side prayer? Dialogue. See, Moses said, Lord, you should not kill them. God would say, okay, Moses. Conversational prayer. In the Old Testament, all could not have it. Abraham had, Lord, if there is 50 righteous people, no matter, I will not destroy. Father, 45, okay, 45. You and I, we don't have the dialogue with God. We only talk. Amen. For that, the Holy Spirit helps you. Are you happy with the Holy Spirit? He helps you to talk to God face to face. Say it. I am a spirit.
I am a spirit. I am a spirit.
God is a spirit.
God is a spirit.
The praying in new language. My spirit language.
My spirit language.
The new creation language.
The new creation language.
Okay? When you pray in Hindi, kya hai? Ab kaise hai? Ye outer man language. Yengana munde? Kalanga kainya? Ye outer man language. Ayo, some people boast about the outer man language. I have an inner man language. Can I tell you? Because I am a spirit, I want to talk more in my inner language than in Tamil or Hindi or English. Al akrosema mamal hata. Akulman Valbiskuru Bahatil Vahatin Mala. Wow. Wow. Jana, you can talk to God like that. That's what the Bible says. He that prays in tongues. 1 Corinthians 14 and 4. Leave it. 1 to 4, you can read it. It's all prophecy and tongues in turn. He speaks secrets, mystery to God. Sometimes I don't need to say. I don't need to understand. If I talk, I don't need to understand everything. The husband and wife, they will talk so many things. Why should I interfere? But sometime, if it is concerning me, I would be interested. What did you say? You said Ezekiel, I heard that name. Please, will you tell me? So sometime, God is a spirit. Jesus is a spirit now. Holy Spirit is a spirit. I am also a spirit. All four will talk some secret. I don't need to know it. Let them talk. And now what are you doing? I am like Joshua. Joshua went to the mountain and he went up to one level. Then God said, Moses, you only come up. Poor Joshua. He didn't go to talk to God. He didn't come to people also. In between standing, shivering in the 40 days. Here, you know, he cannot go and eat chapati curry. He cannot go to God at least. He is not allowed. Here, Moses, one day, second day, third day. Poor Joshua. When I go to Joshua, I will give him a big hug. Then only I will go to Moses to hug. So sometime, my spirit, God's spirit, Holy Spirit, Jesus spirit, they will have a conference. So what the Joshua has to do, I have to allow the spirit to talk. And wait, Mashatri Kulpul Hotur Boswala, Hindelohandil Belehitolobuskin Delegato, Uncle Mara Aval Ben Maskur Bohatil Maskur Mahasko. I don't understand anything. Okay, if it is needed. Sometimes I become curious. I want to know what these four people are talking without me. Then I have a scripture to climb. That's it. He that prays in tongues, that's me, must pray. Yes, I pray.
Interpret.
that he may interpret. That also not he, he. So I pray, Talma Aleska Mahava Ilikur Manklaha Maloski Mahatan Kushbalaha. Some people, you know, the moment they pray in tongues, Amma, Tandalabitan. Yinna Achi, rice boiling, child fallen. Why such a hurry? Some people, the moment they talk in tongues, the whole body, yeah. Even if that continues for half an hour, okay. One second, shandabalandabalandabal. Hey, this is a language. Imagine a dove, a nice soft dove, comes and sits on your shoulder. Shandabalalanda! Where is my bird? Why should you speak like express? Talk. Habalma, avaskurma kabaleva. Lotruman kalitrin saha. Manile suva aha lamrile hatulma helma sava baba klatru man mashko. Sometimes when I pray for interpretation, when I slowly talk in tongues like talking, suddenly the meaning of that language, I may not know the word, I feel it. The voice of God comes like a feeling. For example, if I pray for Mama Belhes Kurma, I bring him in my mind. Ahu Hilas Kurma Balva Nilakut Bala. Suddenly I cry. I know he's going through something that nobody knows. Sometimes when you say, he that prays in tongues must interpret it. You can pray in tongues. Mahatul, so I can demonstrate it here. I can call you and I demonstrate it. I will see. I am more interested in you demonstrating. Now you are going to demonstrate it. Catch somebody and you don't know anything, you say, Lord, I don't know about him. You know about him. Pray in tongues. I give my tongues. You pray for him. Start praying. Don't jump and shiver and halma hero hoskara halputra. Sometimes, you know, the Bible says if there is no interpreter, let him speak himself to God. Most of the time, I can sleep with Annie and she will not understand I am praying in tongues. You can do it all the time. When I was a student, every time I have to go to the town bus or any bus, I will always find a corner seat. So that when the bus starts, the driver will start, this driver also will start. If it is 5 hours time, 5 hours I pray. So when you go by car, if there is a traffic jam, you must be very happy. Wow, I can charge my battery more. Ayyo, battery jam, a traffic jam. Ayyo, battery charge illa, battery loose aayidu. So you have to pray. Alaskar Bahatil Vala. Listen, sometimes that could be a prayer form. Read it now. Read it now. Very simple to interpret it. Extremely simple. Read it.
Therefore, let him who speaks in a tongue pray that he may interpret.
Read it again.
Therefore, let him who speaks in a tongue.
Ah.
Pray that he may interpret.
Listen. Pray. Everybody say, he that prays in tongues, speaks in tongues.
He that prays.
Say it. Speaks in tongues.
Speaks in tongues.
Must pray.
Must pray.
That he may interpret.
That he may interpret.
Okay. Then what to do? Pray. 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 For 10 years. You have to pray and believe. Only believe. I'm asking you a question. When you pray something according to God's will he give or no?
Yes.
So what you have to do? Hala askirimen mala hatto tal baskovar bahashkola bahatilko. Lord, according to 1 Corinthians 14, 13, you say, I must pray for interpretation. Now, I am praying for this brother. Give me interpretation. Thank you for giving me. Then next step, next word.
For if I pray in a tongue, my spirit prays, but my understanding is unfruitful. What is the conclusion then?
What is the conclusion then? Everybody say, what is the conclusion?
What is the conclusion?
What I am supposed to do?
What I am supposed to do?
How to interpret it?
How to interpret it?
Very simple. Now you are going to be shocked. Can I tell you? Bible is simple. People don't believe because it is too simple. When I tell you something very hard, you will believe it. Very simple. Very simple. What is the conclusion? Say it.
I will pray with the Spirit.
I will. Everybody say, I will.
I will.
Pray with the Spirit.
Pray with the Spirit.
Then.
And I will also pray with the understanding.
Clap your hands. Very easy. You know what you have to do? Pray in tongues, then ask for interpretation. Don't wait for any goosebumps. Immediately you say, thank you Lord, now I am going to interpret. Pray in Hindi, pray in English, pray in Tamil, pray in Malayalam. Anna, I only pray. Yes, you only pray. That is interpretation. Yes. How, Anna? I showed you on that day. First natural, then spiritual. That's one of the most powerful truth we have to learn when we flow in the supernatural. I told you on that day, when somebody is sick, first naturally you go lay hands, then naturally command, then the spirit of healing go. Do you believe that? Okay, how do I preach? When I come here, how I start? I, like that, the Holy Ghost pushes my tongue. I say, how are you? Natural or? Are you happy? You are the best batch I ever heard here. Is it natural or supernatural? Huh? I talk naturally. So what I do, I start my pump, the pump starting timer. Imagine, I am a prophet, I come here. You are all clapping your hand. 1 hour, 2 hours. You know, I am expecting God to suddenly come, push my tongue, pull my mouth, lips up, and gives natural. First natural, then spiritual. First natural man, then the spiritual man, second Adam.
Amen.
So what you have to do? Pray in tongues, okay? Even now we will pray. Lift up your hand and say, Father,
Father, now
I am going to speak in tongues.
I am going to speak in tongues
for my brothers and sisters
for
here.
My brothers and sisters here.
You said it.
You said it.
I must interpret it.
I must interpret it.
I must pray for it.
I must pray for
it. In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I want to interpret.
I want to interpret.
Yes, Lord, I am ready.
Yes, Lord, I am ready.
Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
Use me.
Use me.
Reveal.
Reveal.
The interpretation.
The interpretation.
Of the tongues I speak.
Of the tongues I speak.
Thank you.
Thank you.
For doing it.
For doing it.
Now what you have to do? You will go now and catch somebody. And that someone you should not know earlier. Another thing, they must understand your language. Malayalam na Malayalam, Tamil na Hindi. Otherwise you don't go and talk Marathi. And that man is a Malayali. He doesn't know anything. For him both the language are tongues. They will think, oh, he spoke two languages. So catch somebody of your own language. And I finished, I started with that. I didn't finish. Isaiah 9:10-11 says, listen to me. We read it. With 11 words says, with stammering lips and strange language, I will speak to these people. I don't know how to tell you. Sometime, he himself will talk. You know how I interpret? When I am very broken, confused. Then I interpret to myself. Hey, why you are so worried about it? Why are you so shaken by that? Why do you make people as very big? Am I not living in you? Did I not called you as a prophet? How many things I have did you? Why you doubt me, my son? Be quiet and trust me. Albetin kalvo, maris korbil, yetin kolbarahato. Do you know what I have planned for you, my son? My son, your problem is you are looking here and there. Why not you look the reverse, my son? I am the one who has a surprise for you. Surprise for you. Then I want to tell him what is that surprise. I don't speak in my language. Then I again. Mahotil Sovirbalka. I will not tell you the surprise, but that surprise will be coming to you within 5 days. Imagine if you God could speak through your tongue and he can give you interpretation, how much notebooks you can fill by just interpreting your own language. At that time, the devil will come. Ezekiel taught you, hey, you are speaking to yourself from your own self. That doubt came even when you spoke in tongues first time. That doubt comes every time you pray for sick people. You can touch him, in the name of Jesus, be healed. And you think he might die, eh? The that will be there because he is a spirit of doubt. But what is your faith? God said, I must pray for interpretation. Number two, it is according to God's will. Number three, I prayed, I got it. Number four, I start naturally and it goes into the supernatural. Sometimes, you know, when I pray in tongues, I go to sleep. Morning, when I open the notebook and pen, when I started writing, the whole 10-day subject will come in 1 hour. I don't know how to explain you all this. Did you understand this? Did you understand this? Sometimes I am so heavy. Pali bakkasimanamala yangal matrumala valamreka. And immediately, hey, why are you crying, Ezekiel? Did they call you or did I call you? Why you lose your heart so quickly? I am the one who separated you from your mother's womb. How could that man stop your ministry, Ezekiel? Relax, Ezekiel. Shapatul balkritro naviskarbehatta. Ezekiel, I don't see you as a grown-up man. I see you as a small baby. You all look at me, Anna, enna crazy pagal ho gaya, Anna. You can do that. Sometimes when you pray in tongues and rest it, take your pen and start writing. The interpretation can come in writing also. Suddenly you will write 25 pages without thinking. You won't even read the Bible. Mada. You know what is that? You stored it in your inside, suddenly it downloaded. Did I make it clear to you? I want to tell you another good news. Praying in tongues or speaking in tongues plus interpretation is equal to prophecy. That's why Paul says, I wish that you all prophesy unless you interpret your language. So, praying in tongues, interpreting is prophecy. Number one, you can prophesy to yourself. You can interpret to yourself. Then first you try for you. Then you try for one or two people. Joseph had a dream. First he believed it. Then he shared it with the people. Then after some time he shared it with the co-prisoner. Then a time came, he went to the king. It grows. Everybody say it grows. Yesterday I told you, your baby runs into the sea, your mommy runs into the ocean, and daddy, I told you, that's the levels of growth as you practice, as you go into the spirit. I want to tell you one good news and bad news. When all of you begin to hear God like this, all the prophets will become jobless. The prophets will think, ayyo, I could have given him so many prophecy and had a big offering. Rather, you would start giving prophecy to the people. Any situation, pray in tongue. Any sickness, pray in tongue. Any attack, pray in tongue. Start interpreting. Right. Keep doing it. The devil will say it's your own thought. Yes, your own thought. First 2-3 sentence, maybe your own thought. You started naturally. 5-6-7-8-9-10 will be the Holy Ghost thought. There is a presence, manifested presence in this place. I want to tell you, even there is a healing presence in this place. Even healing presence. Thank you, Lord. I thank you, Holy Spirit. I thank you, I thank you. Now I just want you to pray in tongues and keep moving, keep moving, keep moving. Get out of your chair. Come. And find a new person that you don't know anything about. Everybody, now you are acting on the word. Faith is an act. Malmarakando la bashkaha. Urmanna la balabreka taralaba. Ohuskar bahando la barashka. Ulmarakanda la rahato skarabaha. I love you, Lord. Jesus, name above all name. Go and catch somebody, new person. Beautiful Savior, glorious Lord. Ask him. Don't start praying. Don't start praying till I tell you. Don't do anything, please. Catch somebody, everybody. Emmanuel, God is with us. Blessed Redeemer, living Word. Are you listening? Are you listening? Listen, now talk to that person. What's your name? Be natural. Don't come into a spiritual mood. No tension, no tension, no panicky. What's your name? Where are you from? Happy to see you. Talk something. Talk something. How many children you have? Mandala Rabba. Are you married? Listen. Listen. Now. Just relax. I tell you, the more you stop fearing, the more the gifts will operate. Like a shundara bishundara. Relax. The more you relax, the more the river will carry you. Hello? Now, you ask them, can I pray for you? Ask them, can I pray for you? Okay, first, listen. First, one person, you will pray for another person. After that, that person will pray for you. Agreement. Okay, now listen. Now listen. Very relaxed way, pray in tongues. And don't shake that person. It's not full of dust. And silent, ordinarily, al-bahatin so. And that person must be in your mind. Hala, tonko, skraba. Like that, pray, pray, pray. After prayer, listen, listen. As you are praying, watch your feeling. How you feel? Or, see your imagination, mind. Any picture coming? What do you see in the mind? You imagine, you know? Can you imagine chicken curry now? Can you imagine there is a biryani, yellow biryani? Can you imagine a piece inside? Can you imagine you have your plate is full? See, you saw it, you know? Like that, when you pray in tongue, suddenly in the mental picture, because the Holy Spirit or demon spirit or you, all of you imagine here only. So sometimes some picture will come. Aram say, you can say, sister, I saw this picture. Do you see any connection? Say it. If they say no connection, don't panic. I missed it. Some of you first time learning to swim. Sometimes the water will go into the mouth and nose. Don't worry. Nothing you lose. That's what I want to say. Nothing you lose. Attempt, amma. First attempt, a child will not running for a running race. Relax. And one word. Or if you don't get anything, pray in tongue and start praying in English or Hindi or Malayalam. Just ordinary prayer. Ordinary pray. As you pray, 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 pray. Some of the words you never thought you will be praying. Did I make it clear? Pray in tongue, then pray in Malayalam. Pray in Hindi. And don't stop quickly. Stick, pray, keep praying, 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 praying. Five, two, three sentence will be your sentence. Fourth, suddenly you will say some other sentence. Don't fear. Okay? In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, start. Hold Mara. Listen, did each of you give word or only one person gave word? Okay. Number one. Number two, sometimes when you start, it would be very simple. Maybe you have to pray in tongues again, again interpret. Again, again interpret it. It's a practice. Okay. Okay. Now it's your first time. Some of you take your footstep. Now, listen. Let me check the first attempt. How many mark? Listen. How many of you heard a word which you feel it's very correct for you? Lift up your hands. My God. Nalla. Lift. First attempt is so many. First attempt. Okay, can you bring few testimony? Run here, run here.
I was praying for that auntie, and God showed me a vision. Vision that she had a sister, and I told her that auntie, you are having a sister. She told that yes, I have a sister. Then again I prayed in tongues. God showed me that she is having some family problem, some issues. So I again pray. So Lord, means I hear a voice of Holy Spirit that that's her sister doesn't want good for her in her life. So say her to pray more for her family. So whatever God has told to me, I said to auntie, and it was true. And I really blessed that first time. It was
first attempt. Auntie sister and the sister's family problem and the sister sick up first attempt. Some people pass after 3 attempts. Don't worry. Where is that auntie? Even sonna the correct? 100%. Poyella udaliya. She is not jute nai bola hai. 100% right. Say thank you, Jesus.
This pastor prophesied for him regarding how God saved him from accidents. God protected him from many accidents. He prophesied regarding that.
Will you give me prophecy?
Kya aap mujhe ek bhavishyavani denge? This brother got the name of his wife and he prophesied. And he said, you have 2 children. Name calling prophecy.
You call his wife's name. Kaise malum hai aapko?
Parmeshwar ne bataya.
Kya naam bataya?
Monia.
Monia ask. Apra, how many children you have? 2. He said 2 child. Great. Go. Now, listen to me. Say it with me. He that prophesies, prophesy according to faith.
When you have a
stronger faith, you will have a deeper prophecy. Okay?
God told everything about his family.
Shout out. What? Not everything. What?
What they are doing? They are doing agriculture and
he. They are doing agriculture.
He is having 1 sister.
He has only 1 sister, yeah. Not 2. One sister, then.
And he is having some financial problems.
Financial problem, unda.
Next, his salary. How he is earning now?
How is he earning?
8,000.
8,000 salary. My God. Listen. See, don't be discouraged. But this boy could tell even the monthly salary amount. You know what you think? These are all for some high-level preacher. He's an ordinary man.
నేను ప్రేయర్ చేసేటప్పుడు ఈ డేవిడ్ సన్స్ కోసం పచ్చని పొలాలు చూపించారు. యస్, పచ్చని పొలాలు చూపించారు. తర్వాత ఒకింట్లో పరిచర్య, ఒకింట్లో వన్ హౌస్. నెక్స్ట్ రోగులను స్వస్థపరిచే హాస్పిటల్స్.
సీ హియర్, హీ సా హిమ్, సీ హీ ప్రొఫెసైడ్ హిస్ సాలరీ, హిస్ వర్క్ and his sisters, everything. He prophesied, there is a green pasture, you are doing God's ministry, and you go to the hospital and pray and healing happens, and about your ministry, what? He is conducting a house cell group, all he saw it. Okay, wait. Tambi, come. How did you see it? You saw one big angel and bright light,
speaking in tongues. God showed a vision.
How did he give you vision?
And we are talking in tongues.
When you are talking in, how did you get it? Is it a bright or just a mental picture?
Picture only.
How you picture? As you picture biryani, you, for example, you think about your house. Can you see it?
Yeah.
Like that, the picture comes in your mind.
Yeah.
It's not a magic. It's too simple. Everybody say too simple. See, even when I preached, he didn't jump. See, once when people get one word for them, they jump. Some years ago, I was in Kuwait. I wanted to pray. I said, Holy Spirit, give me a prophecy. Those days I was all the time giving prophecy for individuals. Now I stopped it because I cannot give everybody, it's exhausted. So I just stay with my pulpit. And the Holy Spirit told me inside, tell her I love her. Is it prophecy? Again I check, Lord, give me something very special that she is having two children, salary 7,000. Again I heard, tell her I love her. I called her sister. I said, sister, I don't know. God tells me to tell you that he'll love you. I thought after that some more words will come. Nothing came. Immediately that lady started screaming like a baby. I didn't know why. She said, doctor, very sophisticated. Now what he said? Brother, this is the only word I need. I have cancer. My husband doesn't love me. I was so broken. This morning I cried. I don't want anything. Do you really love me? That's the only answer I want. Do you really love me? I want to know it. Because she was so depressed. And I told her nothing. Sister, God wants me to tell you he loves you. That's all he wanted to hear. Clap your hands.
So this is another wonderful testimony. This brother from Maharashtra, he is from Tamil Nadu. When he was praying, God revealed three things. The first thing was he was having some problem in ministry for 11 years. So this brother got that word, 11 years you have problem. So he spoke that. Then whenever he goes to ministry, there is always having a problem in the family. So that also he revealed. Then the third thing, this brother used to pray with Exodus chapter 14, verse 14. He said, God speaks to you through Exodus 14, 14. Hallelujah.
Everybody stand up. Father, we thank you, Lord. We have started. Everybody say, we have started. We have started. We have started the journey of the Holy Ghost. The journey of discovering I have Christ. Thank you, Lord. It's the beginning. We will grow. Shout it. We will grow. We will go higher, higher, higher. In Jesus' name.